I'm Lisa Steele. I'm a fifth generation chicken keeper, author, and master gardener. My grandparents were honest to goodness New England chicken farmers. I grew up across the street from their farm and raised chickens as a kid. Then I headed off to college and a career on Wall Street, thinking my days as a farm girl were over. After almost a decade of living the glamorous life in Manhattan, I found myself married and living on a small Harvey farm in Virginia. And guess what? We started raising chickens. Last summer, we packed up the flock and headed to Maine, where I raised them the old-fashioned way, the way my grandparents did, with a few modern tricks and tips of my own. Sometimes you just can't escape your destiny. When we first started raising chickens, I knew I wanted to do it naturally, without any antibiotics or chemicals, the way my grandparents did. After all, we eat their eggs. That means I spend a lot of time with my girls, they all have names, and I watch them so I know what's normal and not normal, and I can head off any potential problems before they become bigger problems. I started sharing my advice and tips on Facebook and found that there were lots of other people just as interested in raising their chickens naturally as I was. So now I'm excited to bring my Facebook page, Fresh Eggs Daily, to life. Enjoy the show. Family farms and lots of backyards had small flocks of chickens right up through the 1950s. Then women started going back to work and supermarkets started becoming more popular and backyard chickens sort of fell out of favor. But in the last couple years, backyard chicken flocks have made a resurgence. Foodies wanting the freshest eggs possible, to homesteaders wanting to be more self-sufficient, or families just wanting to know where their food comes from and have a healthy source for fresh eggs, are all raising backyard chickens. Good morning. Raising chickens doesn't take that much more time or effort than raising the family dog. They need to be fed and watered every day, eggs need to be collected, they need to be let out at sunrise, and locked in a safe coop at night so they're safe from predators. But other than that, they provide lots of enjoyment and tons of fresh eggs. Today is water bucket cleanout day. Not every day, kind of as needed, but you know, the water buckets and tubs get kind of mucky. So you want to clean them out, and then white vinegar. I just feel it's safer for the chickens and the environment to just use the regular white vinegar. So I just put some white vinegar into the bucket and some water. And then I just use a stiff brush and kind of scrub them out and then just rinse them off. Don't worry much about the outside. And I just leave them to dry in the sun. Sunlight is UV rays are really great at killing pathogens and bacteria. So leaving them out in the sun for the rest of the day to just dry really does a great job of cleaning your water buckets. Clean fresh water is really important year round. Chickens obviously need water. We have ducts, so the water doesn't stay clean very long, but every morning I fill the water tubs with nice fresh water. And then there are a couple of supplements that I add to the water for a healthier flock. I do a lot of preventive to try to boost their immune systems. Apple cider vinegar, you want to use the unpasteurized with the mother. It has great health benefits. It helps respiratory health, it helps with the mucous membranes, and it also helps keep the water cleaner because it helps keep the bacteria down and the algae in the water. So you want to add a tablespoon, a gallon, a couple times a week. That's one thing I add to my water. Also, garlic. Garlic has really great immune system benefits. I just take a clove of garlic, and then I just break it up with my fingers and toss it into the water. It's okay if the chickens fish it out eventually and eat it, but the garlic really helps to build up their immune systems. I don't keep feed and water inside the coop. If you leave it inside the coop, it tends to just attract flies, rodents, makes a huge mess. So feed and water outside, and we use the rubber tubs because of the ducks. Ducks really need a lot of water when they eat, so they'll take a mouthful of feed, a mouthful of water, and go back and forth. But there are all kinds of feeders and waterers on the market. The gravity waterers and feeders that most people use for their chickens are fine. Rubber tubs are fine. So there's all kinds of options. I was really excited when we moved to Maine that I finally had a chance to try Blue Seal feeds. It wasn't available where we were in Virginia, but it's a New England-based feed company, and a couple of friends who live in New England use it for their chickens and goats. I've been using it for about a year, and our chickens love it. There's never any waste. They're really healthy. The Blue Seal has vitamins, minerals. It has calcium for strong eggshells, so it's a balanced diet for them. They have a full line from starter, grower to layer feed. So from about hatch to about 8 weeks, you'd feed the starter, and then 8 weeks to about 18 weeks on the grower, and then switch over to the layer. I have some chickens now that are about 12 weeks old, so we have everybody on the grower feed because they all are in the run together. That gives the little ones the protein they need, and the added protein is actually good for the layers this time of year going into fall because they're growing in new feathers. They're molting. So the extra protein helps them grow their feathers in faster. The layer feed, extra egg layer, I'll switch everybody over to about 18 weeks old. That has added calcium in it for strong eggshells and better egg production. Our chickens love it, and I love that it's a local company so I can support, you know, the local economy and keep our chickens healthy. Another thing I like about the Blue Seal feed is that it comes in both a pellet and a crumble option, not only the layer feed, but also the grower. My chickens prefer crumbles. It's very much a personal preference. Some people say that their chickens won't eat crumbles or they waste a lot. Mine prefer crumble. So I'm really happy that I can get the Blue Seal in the crumble for all stages. So even when your chickens are eating a great quality layer feed, they still need a supplemental calcium source. You can use a commercial oyster shell, or you can crush eggshells. I prefer to use the eggshells. So after we have breakfast, I save the shells. Under running water, I pull the membranes out and I just leave the eggshells in a bowl on the counter. And then when they're dry, I crush them up with my fingers. I always feed them free choice. Each chicken will eat as much or as little as she needs. You just want to leave the calcium in a separate dispenser so the layers can eat the calcium and the ones that aren't laying yet won't touch it. Another thing that I provide to my chickens is grit. You can buy commercial poultry grit. Or if your chicken's free range and they're roaming around your yard, your lawn, they'll go out in the driveway and eat stones. A chicken doesn't have teeth, so when they eat their food, the food collects in their crop, which is kind of to the right over here, and that it'll kind of expand throughout the day with all the food they're eating. And that's where the grit goes too. And as the grit kind of tumbles around, it breaks up the food and digests it for them. You want to feed this free choice again, like the oyster shells. And each chicken will eat as much or as little as she needs.
When my son developed eczema, I needed a better solution. With a rich family history of cultivating natural products, I became a fourth generation soap artisan. My soaps, lotions, and creams are made using natural products, including free range egg. Eggs aren't just for eating. Free range skincare improves the health of your skin, protects the environment, and promotes the humane treatment of chickens nationwide. So how about putting a little egg on your face? Have fun and feel good with free range skincare.
Here at Happy Hen Treats, we're dedicated to bringing our delicious treats to chickens everywhere. We just love chickens. In fact, we love them so much, we hired one. Welcome aboard, Larry.
Whether you have just 5 chickens in your flock or more than 40, Horizon Structures has the coop for you. All Horizon Structures coops are fully customizable. You can choose your door down to the siding colors. You can choose from one of their pre-designed coop styles or even have them convert a garden shed into a custom coop. Made by the Amish in Lancaster, Pennsylvania, the coops can be delivered anywhere in the continental USA, and they'll arrive fully assembled. For more information or to design the coop of your dreams, visit horizonstructures.com.
I love living in the country and raising a garden and chickens, but that means predators. The Night Guard solar predator lights help protect the garden from deer and raccoons and also keep our chickens safe. They are solar powered flashes of light. They're weatherproof, waterproof. They're safe around your pets and other livestock. They come on every night at dusk and they flash all night, every night till dawn. If you're interested in finding out more and keeping your chicken and garden safe from predators, visit the Night Guard website at nightguard.com. There is no one perfect coop design. Coops come in all different sizes and shapes and designs, but every good coop will have some of the same characteristics. The two most important things for your chicken coop are good ventilation and predator proofing. So on your main coop door, the little chicken door, and any nesting box lids or anything, you need predator proof latches. Padlocks or key locks are great. You can use a latch that's secured with a carabiner or a locking eye hook. When you're planning your coop, you want to plan on 3 to 5 square feet of floor space per chicken. And don't plan on the flock you currently have, plan on the flock you eventually want to have. It's easier to start big and grow into the coop than have to add on later. My coop has fully functional windows, so I can open and shut them. There's also vents up high. You want ventilation above the heads of your chickens when they're roosting. You'll need to have 1/2-inch welded wire over all of the openings. That will keep out even the smallest predators, minks, weasels, rats. I also have regular screen on the windows that keeps out the flies. Chickens instinctively seek high ground to sleep. So you definitely want roosting bars for them. You want to make sure that your roosts are staggered, kind of like steps, works out really well. You will want to provide at least 8 inches of roosting bar per hen. In the winter especially, the chickens will all cluster together for warmth and also for balance. The other feature that every good coop needs is nesting boxes. Your rule of thumb is 1 box for every 3 to 5 chickens. You want your boxes to be about 12 inches square, no bigger than 14 inches. You can use wooden crates, you can use milk crates, you can use plastic buckets, just anything that's gonna kind of give them a nice secluded place to lay. And then you'll wanna fill your nesting boxes with some kind of soft bedding material. I like to put a piece of rubber, like an old yoga mat or some rubber shelf liner, cut that to fit each box, and then put your nesting material on top. For the nesting material, you can use straw, you can use shavings. I use curled beech shavings, and I like them because they hold their shape better than typical shavings. I also hang curtains on the front of my nesting boxes. If you keep the eggs kind of shielded from the other chickens and they don't see them, they're less tempted to maybe peck at them and eat them. You want to make sure that your nesting boxes are lower than your roosts because, again, you don't want the chickens to be tempted to sleep in the boxes. You'll also want something on the floor of your coop, not only as a cushioning for when your chickens hop off the roosts in the morning, but also to absorb a little bit of the chicken poop and all that. I use straw, number one, because I just happen to like the smell and the feel of it. We have ducks, they sleep on the floor, they really love straw. Straw also is really a great insulator, so here in Maine in the winter, the hollow shafts of the straw hold in warm air and will keep your coop warmer. Absorbent Products makes a wonderful coop care kit. In the coop care kit is an odor control product. Ammonia will build up eventually in your coop if you don't clean it. Chicken manure is very high in ammonia, so this odor control product neutralizes the ammonia, keeps your coop from smelling. as important as your chicken coop is your chicken run, which is the pen that's attached to your coop, keeps your chickens safe from predators. I have an enclosed run. The chickens are in here for most of the day. Then I let them out in the afternoons to roam around the yard when I can be outside with them. You want a minimum of 10 square feet per chicken. With the run, bigger is definitely better. The more space you can allow them, the better. It'll stay cleaner, they'll stay healthier, less pecking issues. You want to use welded wire fencing. Chicken wire is not predator proof. So on the bottom of the run here, I used half inch welded wire. Same within the coop, that keeps out snakes, rats, weasels, minks, whatever, the smaller predators. I also sunk it down into the ground about 8 inches. We built a trench before we built the run, and the fencing is sunk into the ground to prevent digging predators. You also want to put something on the top of your run. We've just used the plastic poultry netting, which keeps out hawks, eagles, any of the aerial predators. To make it a little more interesting for them, you can put stumps, logs, stones, benches, just anything they can hop up on. And I also have some shade. So we put an old doghouse in the corner of the run. You can make a plywood top that's partly solid. It's a good place to put your feet in water. Just anything where they can have some shade on hot days, get out of the rain. I like to plant bushes and shrubs, some low evergreens, things like that that provide shade and a little bit of color to your run. Chickens don't take baths like dogs or cats or even wild birds. Instead, what chickens do is they take dust baths. They do this to keep their feathers free of oils and clean, and they also do it because the dirt will suffocate any mites or lice or fleas or ticks or anything, any external parasites that decide they might want to live on your chicken. So providing a dust bath area is really important. And basically you just need a large tub, just something that's large enough for one or two chickens to get into. Dry dirt, you can use sand. As part of the Fresh Coop Kit, absorbent powders has a dust bath mix, which I use, and it's the diatomaceous earth, kind of similar to what I use in the coop, but it's a mix for the dust bath. And you can just sprinkle a little of it in and then mix it up in the dust bath. And the diatomaceous earth, as I had mentioned for the coop, is microscopic, tiny little sharp things that pierce the insects' shells. So if you just keep a dust bath area, your chickens should stay healthier.
Your girls deserve the best. When feeding your chickens Blue Seal Home Fresh poultry products, you will be giving them the balanced nutrition they need for their everyday health. You can be fully confident that Blue Seal products not only contribute to their nutrient-rich eggs, but also to the pretty sheen on their feathers. Visit their website, blueseal.com, or your local Blue Seal retailer to learn more.
Sierra Sage Herbs Green Goo is the go-to antiseptic ointment on my farm. I love that I can use it on our chickens, ducks, dogs, and I even use it on myself. Formulated with lavender, rosemary, and other herbs, Green Goo can be used on minor cuts, scratches, and scrapes, as well as frostbite or more serious injuries. No chicken keeper's first aid kit should be without Green Goo. For more information, visit greengoohelps.com.
The folks at Happy Hen Treats are always hard at work developing new products. What you working on here, Larry? Bang.
Whether you have just 5 chickens in your flock or more than 40, Horizon Structures has the coop for you. All Horizon Structures coops are fully customizable. You can choose your door down to the siding colors. You can choose from one of their pre-designed coop styles or even have them convert a garden shed into a custom coop. Made by the Amish in Lancaster, Pennsylvania, the coops can be delivered anywhere in the continental USA, and they'll arrive fully assembled. For more information or to design the coop of your dreams, visit horizonstructures.com.
Another thing I love about keeping chickens is that I can combine my love of chickens and my love of gardening. They both benefit each other. Your chickens will be happily eat any bug-eaten vegetables and produce that you have. They also help. Their manure fertilizes the garden, and they love to go in after the season's over and just kind of turn everything over, look for some weed seeds and bugs. And of course, what you grow in the garden can help feed your chickens, it can supplement their food, give them some nutritious treats that they love to eat. Chickens make really great garden partners, but not during the prime growing season. They'll eat your produce, they'll eat the leaves, they'll basically eat everything in your garden. So during the growing season, you want to keep them out. You want to either fence in your garden, you can use row covers to protect what you're growing from your chickens, or you can keep the chickens penned up. But then during the off season, letting your chickens in to kind of clean up everything. They can eat stems and roots and things. They help turn over the soil as they're scratching, looking for bugs and things. When you're planting your garden, plant a little extra for your chickens. They don't mind things like this, bug-eaten or a little wilted, things you wouldn't necessarily feed to your family, perfect for the chickens. They also love cucumbers, melons, squash, anything in that family, zucchini. You can just cut them in half. They'll eat the seeds and rinds and everything. They like peas and beans. And as I mentioned in the first segment, garlic, adding garlic to your water if you plant some garlic for your chickens. Basically, anything you plant for your family to eat will be fine for your chickens, but there are some exceptions. Tomatoes, eggplant, red and white potatoes, and rhubarb are all members of the nightshade family. They contain toxins. Toxin doesn't mean immediately fatal, but in general, I stay away from feeding these kinds of things to my chickens. Vines and leaves and unripe fruit have more of the toxin, whereas the ripened vegetables have less. But to be on the safe side, I stay away from them. The one exception is I do feed my chickens ripe tomatoes. They love tomatoes, and as long as they're fully ripe, and as an occasional treat, I do feed them. But other than that, you want to stay away from the nightshade family. Apple seeds contain cyanide, so if you feed them a lot of apples, you might want to core the apples. Asparagus can taint the taste of the eggs. So if you feed too much asparagus, your eggs might be a little off tasting. I do stay away from the onions because they're not nearly as nutritious and can be more toxic. Avocados are toxic to most birds, so I would just stay away from feeding them avocados. Basically, what I say is guacamole, onions, avocados, tomatoes, no. Other than that, pretty much anything in the garden that they want to munch on is fine. One of the best things about raising chickens is the fresh eggs they lay, but one of the problems with fresh eggs is that they don't peel well. So if you want to make hard-boiled eggs or deviled eggs, you're going to have a problem peeling your fresh eggs. But I'm going to show you a secret for perfectly peeled eggs, and then I'm going to share my recipe for mayonnaise using fresh eggs that you make right in a mason jar. So my water's boiling in my pot, and I have my bamboo steamer. You can use a rice steamer or even just a colander. I put my eggs that I've rinsed off into the steamer, put the lid on, and then I just set my timer for 20 minutes. So my timer's gone off, it's been 20 minutes. I'm gonna take my eggs and put them into a bowl of ice water. I'm going to crack it a little bit and start peeling, and as you can see, it's a perfectly peeled egg. So one of my favorite things to do with our fresh eggs is to make mayonnaise. You can make it as quick as you can get in the car and go to the store. It's really easy to make. It does use raw eggs, so if you're concerned about consuming raw eggs, just be aware, elderly people with suppressed immune systems or little kids, you might want to not serve them the mayonnaise, but it's really easy to make since these are our eggs. They're fresh, they're clean. I know how the chickens are raised and the eggs are handled. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to separate three eggs, and the yolks go into a mason jar. The whites you can either use for something else or just throw them out. And then to the mason jar, I'm going to add a half a teaspoon of mustard, the juice of a lemon, and then I'm going to add a quarter teaspoon of salt. Now what I want to do is take my immersion blender and I'm just going to pulse it a couple of times to mix everything up. Then I'm going to start using the oil. I have a cup of oil. You can use olive oil, vegetable oil, avocado oil, you know, whatever kind of oil you want to use. You want to add it a tablespoon at a time and then pulse in between. And then once you've added a couple tablespoons, you can just kind of do a steady drizzle while you're pulsing. And that's it. And kind of just like magic, you've got mayonnaise. You can see it's really great consistency. So what you want to do is you can either use it right away or you just cover your jar. You want to let it sit out for up to 12 hours. That kind of lets the lemon juice work and kill any bacteria. And then after that, you'll put it in the refrigerator and it'll be good for about a week to use for sandwiches or egg salad or whatever you want to use.
Chickens can be prone to respiratory issues. At the first sign of any wheezing, sneezing, or sniffles, adding a few drops of VetRx to their water, under their wings, or to their nostrils can help alleviate symptoms. Made in the USA, VetRx is an all-natural product that can be used on all your pets and barnyard animals. For more information, visit their website or ask for the original VetRx at your local Tractor Supply store.
Your girls deserve the best. When feeding your chickens Blue Seal Home Fresh poultry products, you will be giving them the balanced nutrition they need for their everyday health. You can be fully confident that Blue Seal products not only contribute to their nutrient-rich eggs, but also to the pretty sheen on their feathers. Visit their website, blueseal.com, or your local Blue Seal retailer to learn more.
Since 2009, Happy Hen Treats has been supplying our unique brand of treats to chickens across America. Here in our warehouse, we carefully wrap and ship each package. Let's get those packages out, Larry.
Sierra Sage Herbs Green Goo is the go-to antiseptic ointment on my farm. I love that I can use it on our chickens, ducks, dogs, and I even use it on myself. Formulated with lavender, rosemary, and other herbs, green goo can be used on minor cuts, scratches, and scrapes, as well as frostbite or more serious injuries. No chicken keeper's first aid kit should be without green goo. For more information, visit greengoohelps.com. I hope you enjoyed your day on the farm visiting with me and the chickens. Whether you already have chickens or are planning on getting some, I hope fresh eggs are in your future. I have a little tip for you just to close out. If you don't have access to fresh eggs, you can still get the freshest eggs at your supermarket. Each carton of eggs at your grocery store has a 3-digit code on one end. The code will range from 001 to 365, with 001 being January 1st and 365 being December 31st. So all you need to do is look at that code to determine the date that those eggs were put in the carton at the farm. For more fresh eggs daily, visit me on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter, or consider reading one of my books.